expert. So meteorologist Tamara Berg joining us now with more details about what conditions looked like yesterday as that avalanche hit and the rescue efforts underway.
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, yesterday at the Siberia, if you're familiar with the resort, the top of that ridgetop had a wind gust clocked at 106, wow. 106 miles an hour. And that elevation is roughly above 8,500 feet. So yeah, you can imagine, not only did you have the strong and heavy wind, but you have the snow coming down at that point and getting whisked around. And that can typically, in an avalanche situation, generate slabs of snow on the mountain that could give way at any time. So of course, we know we had the snowfall in the forecast. You might also be wondering, you know, what can trigger an avalanche or what is the setup for that? Let me walk over here now and show you exactly what the conditions need to be like. You need a slope. So, you know, the slope there at KT-22, it's a very, very high slope, and you need it to be at about a 35 to 50 degree angle. Snow has to be covering it, which of course we had the storms over the weekend that produced the snow. And then you have to have a layer that is a little weaker than another layer. And then there has to be a trigger. And once you get that trigger, that's what happens and sends down that snowfall and creates the avalanche danger. Now today, expecting that we are going to see a quieter day on the mountain, but of course we have that snow that did fall even up until about 1 o'clock in the morning. This is a live look at radar in the last 6 hours, and we had even some flurries touch down around 3,000 feet. So there is still a danger today. Now the Sierra Avalanche Center, they release a forecast every morning, and here's what their forecast is for today, January 11th. Above the tree line, near the tree line, even below the tree line, we have a considerable threat for avalanches. So again, we're going to be watching this development as we go forward and keeping an eye on those conditions as we get more snow potentially into the week.